Okay. This is for the Ventures Collectors, and some new items that I've added to my collection since, but I think the last video I did was July 2019. So, you know, at least 8 months ago. And what we have first off here is a 8-track tape of, I said 8-track, it's actually a 4-track of the Swamp Rock album. 4-track cassette. This one's sealed. And so, presumably never played. And, 4-track it says there. And the other way we know it's 4-track is these corners here would be cut away, beveled, another way to put it, if this were an 8-track tape. Something more like this back here would happen up here if it were 8-track. So I don't have a 4-track player, but yeah, maybe one day I'll get a hold of one. One day soon. This is a French EP. The French EPs had really neat covers. They were all to do with the space program. They all had to do with I don't think they were looking at the U.S. space program, but a lot of the pictures probably came from that. And so this is only the second one of these I have. I have the Telstar one as well. It's an EP, 4 tracks on here. Action, Stop Action, No Matter What Shape, which was a hit. Not really for the Ventures, though. It was a hit for the T-Bones. A Little Bit of Action, which, as we see, has Vogel, Edwards, Taylor, Wilson as the songwriters. Same as Stop Action, has those 4 songwriters, the Ventures themselves, that is. All right, and moving along, this was a nice find. This is Country Classics, and one of my favorite Ventures albums. It's a little detail. Noki is playing a guitar. This is the first album cover where it's indicated Noki playing guitar. Now, Noki had been playing lead guitar for the Ventures for the first, you know, this is bringing us up to about the 11th album or so, and that's roughly, and on all of those 10, at least 10 previous albums, Noki is shown playing bass, or he's not shown at all on a number of them, so, just a little detail. This is what was great about this particular copy of this album is that I pulled out in a special jacket, so we could see the label. This is an audition record, an audition copy of Country Classics. I don't think I have audition copies of every one of the Fender Years Ventures albums or the Mosrite Years either. But I have a lot of them, and so I was very happy to find this one. I don't know where I'm going to put all these. Just probably stack them back like this. This is another, as you see, copy of Country Classics. And, it's a Japanese copy from the 60s with the Obi strip, so that's pretty nice. I hadn't had that before. And I don't know, it's a red vinyl. I also have this one in a special jacket. Some of these I do that. I want to protect the original jacket. If it's certainly sometimes they start to get a little wear at the down in this area. This one is, I think, in good shape all around. Yeah, it's complete, but still being cautious with it because it's such a nice copy of that particular album. I think I'm gonna move these out this way. Okay, and then here's another Japanese find of a red vinyl Japanese copy of the Ventures today. This was actually the Venture's Horse album. I don't know if they... you'll have to look at my previous video discussing the Horse album. that would tell us whether they changed any songs or added a song or... Yeah, I don't know. I'm not recalling. Something tells me they did, but maybe not. Anyway, it's a nice red vinyl copy that I found, and there's the original inner sleeve. It's got a couple of Ventures albums right here on that that inner sleeve. This is Groovin' the Ventures, which in the U.S. was not didn't have this cover or this title. It was in the U.S. It was called Million Dollar Weekend. I have another copy of this Japanese version, but this one had the obi strip, so if I can find them like that, I'd like to have that. And it's another red vinyl, and then again I'm showing the inner sleeve, although I'm sure if I flip this inner sleeve around, I'll see some Ventures albums advertised. Looks like all classical on that side, but a great one. This was a particularly nice find for me. This is the Going to the Ventures Dance Party album, one of my favorite Fender era albums. It was the last of four albums they dedicated to dances. They did a couple of Twist albums and then Mashed Potatoes and then this one. And then this one didn't sell so well, so they changed. Decided on the next album they better change things around. This album had a lot to do with dances. This album was made in the summer, I think they started this, of 1962. The Ventures, Don and Bob and Don only, had gone to Japan and had returned in June of 1962, and were to deliver an album. I think they had to have it to the label in August, and they also had a busy performance schedule, and so they split up. And I'm talking about the what we call the original four, or the celebrated four anyway, Mel Taylor and Noki and Bob and Don. So in that part of the year, the summer of 62, after they'd returned from Japan, they decided to split up and send half the band out on tour and half the band would stay in the studio. Well, you know, normally they would have done that with Don and Bob going out on tour. But you wouldn't have the other guys playing in the studio. The Bob and Don, you know, would hire different bass and drums wherever they went. But because they were going to leave somebody in the studio, you needed either Bob or Don there, being the leaders and actually being the Ventures at that time. In that part of the summer of 62, Don and Noki went out on tour, and there's a, it's a, I've seen it on, I think on YouTube, the recording of up in Oregon, I think it's Portland, Oregon, Division Street Corral. They're playing at some show that was done on Saturday nights from a car dealership, and the Ventures played live, and you'll hear this commercial in that recording. It was recorded by a fellow who worked, the tape that exists today, because it was recorded by a fellow who worked at the radio station, and he heard the Ventures were coming in. They were a favorite of his, and he, at home, set up his reel-to-reel tape recorder so that he could record the show off his home radio, but he was working in the radio station, working for the radio station that night. So he didn't get I don't know why, or maybe because it probably wasn't allowed that he didn't record at the station, but he did record it from home. I know the individual's name, and I don't want to say it because I haven't cleared this with him. But anyway, it's wonderful that he did record the Ventures that night, And it's a wonderful live recording of Noki and Don. And I was saying they did a commercial. They play a commercial on that show where it says Don talking and say, listen tonight or come on down to the car dealership tonight where Noki and I will be playing. And I heard that and I thought, well, why didn't he mention Bob and Mel and or just say the Ventures will be playing? Well, it's because it was only Don and Noki. I'm still going on and on about that. But what is so exciting about this, to me, this particular copy of this great album, an album that had Darlene Love singing on it, by the way, Billy Strange and Bob stayed behind to record, at least started the sessions. I think Noki had to have been involved because his song Night Drive is on here. Don's great song Gandhi Dancer is on here. But I was saying Darlene Love did some of the vocals on here. Hank Levine is on the piano or harpsichord. David Gates is on the bass. Those were the players, along with Billy Strange on lead guitar, started the sessions for this album. And The Intruder, you can't quite read the whole title there, is a Billy Strange title. I think he also has a Limbo track on here. I don't think his is Limbo Rock. I see that one there, but I think Billy Strange did, isn't there a different Limbo? Well, then it is Limbo Rock, is Billy Strange's tune. It was just a great album. It was an album that I had trouble finding in the early 80s, and I finally found a copy. So I've always loved this album, because it's also a great album. Period. But there are a lot of vocals. Locomotion has some vocals on it. Sweet and Lovely does. What else? Oh, and of course, it's Lalita Yaya is in here somewhere. Oh, there's Yaya Wobble. But and so you have Darlene Love involved in at least some of those vocals, and her group, The Blossoms. And so that's a nice detail on that. Now, why another reason I'm so excited to get this a Japanese version from the early 70s in the Ventures Rock and Roll series is that it completes a collection of 13 Ventures albums repressed in Japan. Ventures albums from the 60s that were repressed in Japan in the early 70s. And when I say completes the collection where I've got all the OV strips, I'll flip through them here. I've shown the others, most of these others in various videos. But these were released in the early 70s. You're going to see it's big on the Fender years. There's this second album, the third album. By the way, they have different back covers. And I've shown these again before. But so I won't show all the back covers. But, these are wonderful pressings for the audiophile. And heavy on the Fender years. They did not every Fender years album, but most of them in this series were repressed. And here we are at some Mosrite era albums, but they only did three. So that would be 10 Fender era albums and 3 Mosrite era Ventures albums. And then later in the later 70s into the early 80s, they would, Liberty decided to press the Mosrite. They went heavier with the Mosrite albums. They did a couple of Fender era albums, I think, on the GXH series. And this is Terry Tarucci and his Blue Jeans plays the Ventures. Ventures Best Hits 24. And that's that was a nice find. That's a Japanese album. Very hard to find. This was the first time I saw this and had to have it. It's obviously a great album. This is the inner paper on that Rock and Roll series that we're seeing here, and it's got the 13 albums I was talking about, all 10 of them being the Fender up to there, and then we have the three
Moog right era. Interestingly, they didn't put In Space. Maybe that wasn't as big in Japan, as I know that Walk Don't Run Volume 2 and Knock Me Out were quite big albums in the Japanese market for the Ventures. Anyway, that's it for this go-round for March of 2020. We're already into here. And until next time.